पेज नंबर 133, चैप्टर नंबर 10, हैबिटेट लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड देयर सराउंडिंग्स। दिस इज द डिस्कशन ऑफ मॉड्यूल 3। थ्रू दिस इंटरैक्टिव वीडियो सिस्टम वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंट अडेप्टेशन फॉर द डिफरेंट एक्वाटिक लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स सच एज द अडेप्टेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट एक्वाटिक एनिमल्स and the adaptation of the plant, they are called the hydrophytes. In our previous video we had discussed about the adaptation of the living organism basically adaptation in all living organisms irrespective of the plants or animals make them able to live comfortably in the particular habitat. First, I would like to discuss the different adaptation of the different aquatic animals. First is the adaptation of the fish. We know that fish is the aquatic animal and the habitat of fish is the water or the any water bodies. There are different adaptations of the aquatic animal, the fish, and they are as follows, such as number one, the scales. The body of the fish is covered with the scales and the scales help to protect the fish from decaying under the water. The next type of adaptation found in the fish is called the boat-shaped structure of the body of the fish, and the shape of the body of the fish boat is shaped, it help mainly the fish to swim in the water properly. The fins are also the special type of features or the characteristics found in the body of the fish. It is very important to know that instead of the limbs, lower limbs and the upper limbs, the legs and the hands, the fish has the fins. And this owing to this special type of characteristics or adaptation found in the body of the fish, the fins help the fish to swim in the water and the fins act as the oars in the body of the fish in order to change the direction in the water. The another type of characteristics or a special type of features found in the body of the fish is called the transparent membrane. It is known to us that the eyes in the fish are without the eyelids. The eyelids covered with the transparent membrane, and this transparent membrane protects the eyes of the fish from damaging under the water. The another type of adaptation found in the body of the fish is called the gills. Unlike the other animals, fish breathe through the gills. Gills are called the respiratory organ for the fish instead of the lungs. And we know that fish engulfs the water through its mouth, and this engulfed water comes out through these gills present in the body of the fish, and these gills help the fish in absorbing the oxygen, the air from the water, and also the gills help the fish in proper breathing by absorbing the oxygen present in the water. These are the different characteristics of the features which are collectively called the adaptation found in the body of the fish. Now, what are the different adaptations that are found in the body of the duck and other watery birds? The light weight with the hollow bones. These are the different characteristics or the features called the adaptation found in the body of the duck or in any other watery birds, which help them to stay afloat on the water. Another type of adaptation found in the body of the duck is called the feathers. These feathers are oily in nature, and these feathers keep the bird, the water birds, or including the ducks, help them to keep water away. These oily feathers help the ducks and other water birds to keep the water away from their body. Another type of adaptation found in the body of the ducks and the other water birds is called the webbed feet. Due to this presence of the webbed feet, the duck and other water birds can easily swim in the water. The another type of adaptation found in the body of the duck and other watery birds is the beak. The beak present in the body of the duck and other water birds is specially modified to pick up the water, insects, and the fish for the food. That means, by taking the help of the beak, the ducks and other water birds easily pick up the water, insects, and other fish for their food. Whales and the dolphin. These are also called the other type of animals found in the water habitat. But they are quite different from the fish, because whales and dolphins breathe through their lungs. Lungs is called the special type of adaptation found in the whales and the dolphins, although they are called the fish. They don't breathe through the gills, because gills are absent in the body of the whales and the dolphin. They breathe through the lungs instead of the gills. They breathe air through the lungs, and in order to absorb the oxygen of the atmosphere or the air, they need to come to the surface of the water, and then they can breathe the air through the nostrils present in their body. It should be noted that at a time they breathe heavily, which is sufficient to keep them in water for at least 10 to 30 minutes. Flippers is another type of adaptation found in the body of whales and the dolphins. And these flippers are used for steering and the balance of the body. Now we are going to discuss about the different adaptation found in the plants. Plants which grow in the water are collectively called the hydrophytes. I repeat, plants those grow in the water are collectively called the hydrophytes. Hydro means the water and the phytes means plant. Hydrophytes are mainly those plants which live in the water. That means water is treated as the habitat for these plants called the hydrophytes. Now, what are the different adaptations found in the hydrophytes? First is that they grow in the water bodies such as ponds, pools, lakes and the rivers, and these are called the habitats for the hydrophytes. Following are the different adaptation found in the body of the hydrophytes, such as number one, the mucilage. It is very important. All hydrophytes have their body covered with the mucilage. That means the body of the hydrophyte is covered with the mucilage, and this mucilage protects the body of the hydrophytes from the decaying under the water. Another type of adaptation found in the body of the hydrophyte is called the waxillar. The surface of the leaves of the plant is coated with the waxillar, and this waxillar can protect the surface of the leaves from rotting in the water. And such kind of waxillar on the surface found on the lotus leaves and the water lily leaves. Hence we can say waxillar on the surface of the leaves of the water lily and the lotus is the special type of characteristic or the adaptation found on the leaves of the lotus and the water lily. The another type of adaptation found in the hydrophytes is the stem, long and narrow stem, and the ribbon like leaves. The hydrophytes which mainly live in the streams having long and narrow stem and the ribbon like leaves, and owing to the presence of the long and narrow stem and the ribbon like leaves, this kind of the hydrophytes can easily be able to float along with the current of the water without any damage. The main reason behind this, the presence of the long and narrow stem and the ribbon like leaves. The another type of adaptation found in the hydrophytes is called the reduced structured root. Mainly the hydrophytes having the roots which are highly reduced, and that's why we can say the root don't serve any type of special function in the hydrophytes. The another type of adaptation we can find in the hydrophytes body is called the ear spaces. Mainly the stem of the hydrophytes is full of ear spaces, and such as we can take the example of the lotus leaf. The stem of the lotus is full of the ear cavities or the ear space, and the presence of the ear space or the ear cavities in the stem of the lotus help this lotus plant in floating as well as in absorbing the gases, means the oxygen, for different life activities. In our next video we will discuss about the adaptation for the terrestrial habitat. Thanks for watching.